What is next for Ryan Garcia? Well, Oscar De La Hoya, he's in Phoenix right now with Jaime Munguia, who's fighting tonight. And Oscar De La Hoya is telling reporters that 2 weeks ago he got instructions to set up the Devin Haney fight, and that Devin Haney's father, Bill Haney, is out there, and he's going to meet up with Bill Haney to discuss a possible fight between Devin Haney and Ryan Garcia. Now, something interesting that happened, once the Rowley fight kind of went out of the picture because Rowley's fighting Pitbull Cruz, Bill Haney posted the following and Devin shared it. Check this out. When you keep it positive, it comes back. Salute. So it sounds like they wanted the Ryan fight. To me, this is how I interpret it. They kept it positive. They didn't get another fight. There was talk, of course, Sandra Martin signed with Top Rank, which a lot of people speculated that Devin Haney will sign with Top Rank and keep that going. But now it looks like it's going to be pay-per-view on DAZN with Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney. Obviously, it's all speculation. Nothing's fact. But Oscar De La Hoya says he's going to meet with Bill Haney. And I know Oscar. I know Oscar wants to put on the biggest fights. I know Oscar cares about events. I know Oscar works with all the promoters. Oscar is an 11-time champion in six divisions, a 1992 gold medalist. And he's very passionate about boxing. Oscar has money. He doesn't have to be in boxing. A lot of people don't have a choice, but they're in boxing because they don't have a choice. It's this and nothing. Oscar is good. He could walk away from boxing, and he doesn't miss it, but he loves it, and he's passionate about it, and he cares about boxing, and he cares about the sport that's so important to him. Since he was a young child, he's been in this sport. So I know for a fact he wants to put on the best fights. He wants to put on the biggest events, and that's what it's all about. So Ryan Garcia, Devin Haney, 140 champion, coming over that big win over Regis Progress. He's the WBC champ. Ryan Garcia has fought Devin Haney 6 times in the amateurs. They're 3-3. Ryan is a generational talent. I know a lot of people discount him. A lot of people say this and that about him. But listen, he's the real deal. Not only that he's popular, that's just a plus. But he's a 15-16-time national champ. Ryan is 24-1 with 20 knockouts. And he's, according to BoxRec, they have him ranked 6 in the world. Not only 6 in his division, but 6 in the world. And BoxRec have their own way of calculating. It's not popularity vote. It's not. This is based on numbers and facts. It's based on their mathematics of your opponents, their wins, their losses, who they've won, who they've lost to, and so on and so forth. He beat Campbell Hatton, Olympic medalist. And he's pretty much, he beat Duno, they didn't give him a chance. And he just come, Oscar Duarte, they didn't give him a chance, he just knocked him out. So it's definitely an intriguing fight, and it's not guaranteed that it's going to happen, but it looks like that's what Oscar De La Hoya is trying to make. Now, Devin has to do his mandatory, he has to do his mandatory. That's Sandor Martin. And Ryan could fight anybody. Oscar also says that maybe Ryan will move up to 47. That's also an option. He could fight Golden Boy, have 147 pounders, or if Crawford, it is how it works, Crawford vacates the 147 belt, Ryan could fight for a belt to 147. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, actually 3 belts, because Boots Ennis has 1 belt. And Boots, again, is with Allen. He fights in Amazon Prime. So it has to be fighters either Top Rank, Golden Boy, Matchroom, and so on and so forth. So there's a lot of options for Ryan. He could fight for the title at 40. He could fight for the title at 47. But very, very interesting week in boxing. It's never boring. You blink, you think you have a fight, you go to bed, you wake up, that fight's gone. And that happens. It happens a lot. So many times you just have to wait until the two fighters are in the center of the ring and they're shaking gloves before their fight to actually see the fight happen. But Isaac Cruz is fighting Rowley. Both Rowley and Isaac Cruz were negotiating the fight. Ryan, I thought the Ryan and Rowley fight was a massive fight, a big fight, a fight that I couldn't wait for the trash talk at the press conference, the lead-in, the fight itself. But that may happen in the future. You never say never in boxing. Look, Devin Haney told Ryan just a few weeks ago, never mention my name again. And then something came up and Devin mentioned Ryan's name. So nothing is ever final in this business, ever. What did Bob Arum say once? It's not personal. It's business. So you never burn bridges. That's what Bob Arum said. So Bob could criticize a fighter, then love a fighter, then criticize him, then sign him, then give him the biggest payday of his life, and then criticize him again. It's just the way the sport works, so you can't really hold a grudge for life. It's best not to. So here's my question to you guys. If this fight does happen now, who do you like? Who do you think pulls it off? Do you go with Ryan Garcia? Do you go with Devin Haney? Is it a draw? If it wins, who wins by knockout? Who wins by decision? And there you have it. Stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. And if it's not Devin Haney, what do you think Ryan Garcia does next? FayeUsNewsReporting.com. I'm Melisek back reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Segback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Segback. I'm Ellie Segback, Ellie Segback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting.